Good morning students and welcome back to your online class once again. Today in this video tutorial we are going to learn about mail merge. Before I begin the practical, let us see that what is mail merge. What is mail merge? Mail merge is actually a feature which incorporates the data from both Microsoft Word and Excel, which allow you to create multiple documents such as letters, which saves your time for retyping the same letter again. So which means that in mail merge we have the facility to write multiple letters at once. How it can be done? You have to create a list of recipients whom you want to send the letters, which can be done in Excel and in Word itself. And then you have to write a sample letter, or you can say a particular formal letter where no names will be written. And then you can merge it with the list of recipients and it will create the number of letters you want. So let us begin the practical and understand it more clearly. So students, as you can see that I have opened Microsoft Word in front of me, and today I am going to show you the practical of mail merge. So to use this feature of Microsoft Word, we are going to write a formal letter, a formal birthday letter inviting all of my friends for my birthday party. So let us begin and write the sample letter first of all. I am writing here, dear, and then you are heartily invited for my birthday party, which is organized by my family at Hotel Shyam on 29th June at 7 p.m. onwards. Your presence is extremely important for me. Yours lovingly. Now you can write your name. So here the formal letter is written. Now I am going to start the mail merge process. So for that you have to go to the mailing tab, which is here on the top. Click on start mail merge. Here you can go step by step, we have to go. So from here you can click start mail merge, and then you can select the recipient and then you can edit it. I am going to click here. Instead of going step by step, I am clicking on the option step by step mail merge wizard. So it will give me all the steps over here. So I am clicking it. Now you can see that on the right side there is a wizard open in front of me. Here you have to click what type of document are you working on. So I will click on letters because I am writing a letter. Then and at the bottom you will see that there is written next starting document. So you will click on next. Then it is giving you the option, select starting document. How do you want to set up your letters? Use the current document. It means, do you want to use this document as a letter? Yes. So click on next. Now it is asking you to select the recipients. So if you have a recipients already ready with the Excel list, if you have written the recipients name in Excel, so you can click on use an existing list option, or click on type a new list. I will click on type a new list and click on create. Once you click on create, here you can write the title and the first name of your friend. So let me write only the name of my friends. I am not avoiding the title to be written. So here I will write, suppose, Ram, and then I click on new entry. Then again write here Priya, then new entry, suppose Priyansh. Then new entry, and suppose I am writing here again Sujata. So these are four names I have written. You can write n number of recipients, whatever you want. Click on OK. So now my recipient list is ready. It is asking me to save the file. So click any location. I am clicking the desktop so that it is easy to locate the file, and I will save my file with the name anything. So I am writing here recipient_list. And then click on save. it is saved. So now you can see that the four names are saved. You have to select a data source, the name, the file which is created. Click on this and press OK. So this recipient list is being used now to create a letter. Now the next option you will get at the bottom is that write your letter. So click on write your letter. Now I have to organize that where your address should be given and how the letter should be written. Letter is, by default letter is already written, but you have to decide that how it should be shown to the your friends. So for showing it to the friends, you have to now select that how the letter should be shown and what are the steps. So you can see that on the right side it is written write your letter. So I'll click on write your letter. The letter is already written. So on the top you can see there's the address block written, greeting line written. So you have to click on address block and place it after the dear, so that the name which I have added of my friend, the address which I have added, it should be added after dear. So I will place my cursor after dear, give a space and click on address block. Address block, you can see all the names are coming over here, whatever name I have added in my list of recipients. So it is added and press OK. So it is, dear address block is written. Now when once I click on preview my letter, it will be showing me all the names. It will create the letter of all my friends. So just click on the bottom side, right bottom, and it, you can see that it is written dear Ram and the letter is here. You can click on the recipient 2, you will get the second letter. You will click on recipient 3, it will show you the third letter, fourth, and whatever names, how as many names you will add, the letter will be shown to you. Now click on complete the merge. Once you click on complete the merge, it will give you the option of printing it. Once you click on print, you can print the entire document with different names. So it will create the different letters for different friends, and you can send those letters to n number of friends by taking the printout. This is how the mail merge works. Now as the printer is not attached, so it will not be printed in my system right now, but you can follow these steps to print all the letters in one go. So this is going to help you, and you can save your time by using mail merge. You can just send a single letter, send it to different people. All right, I hope you have understood the mail merge topic. Now you practice it at home. Now we have to finish our exercise questions also. We have already discussed it. Let me tell you once again. The first question is, what is formatting? Formatting actually refers to the layout of the page. Whatever page is there, how it is represented, what is the appearance of the page, how the text looks, it all refers to formatting. Now the second question is, what are header and footer in MS Word? So header refers to the text which is added at the top of every page of the document, and footer refers to the text which is placed at the bottom of every page of the document. The importance of header and footer is that it gives us the facility to repeat a particular text in every page of the document. In spite of, you don't have to write it every time, you just go into header and footer and write the text which you want to repeat in every page of the same document. The third question is that, what is page margin? Page margin actually refers to the white space or the space which is left from the edges of the text, from the left, right, top and bottom. Whatever the space is left, that is refers to as page margin. And what is line spacing? Line spacing refers to the spacing between the two lines or two sentences. And what is paragraph spacing? It refers to the space between two paragraphs. So these all are the questions which are related to this chapter. Apart from these, there are the steps that how you do all these works, like adding header and footer or adding a page margin or paragraph margin. So you have to follow the steps which I have discussed in the previous videos. So students, do watch all the videos carefully for completing this chapter. Complete your notes and send it to me. If you have any query, do send or a mail or write to me. And till the time, stay safe and happy. Thank you so much.